As long as First Nation people have lived in what is now Manitoba, they've known of the land the Anishinaabe call Wowaswajikas, the hill of the buffalo chase. A rich country of forests and grasslands. The jewel at its center is called Wasagaming.
The lake itself, our pronunciation is Washagamesagegan. They always made a reference to this lake as a sacred in terms of, you know, for us to come for peace and quiet, for peace and security, to meditate, to be close to nature and to be close to the Creator.
Since the early 1700s, treaties signed with First Nations have paved the way for the peaceful settlement and development of much of Canada. Keeseekoowenin First Nation received its reserve near Elphinstone under Treaty 2, signed in 1871. A fishing station on nearby Clear Lake became reserve land in 1896, and the reserve was expanded in 1906. When Riding Mountain National Park was established in 1930, the reserve land at Clear Lake ended up inside the park boundaries. In 1935, the government of the day took the land away from the First Nation without their consent, and it became part of the park.
So they all had to come and live in this little 4x3 reserve, while they had all this land that was taken away, plus Clear Lake Reserve. So, and later on I understood it was frustration and anger, and yeah, shame, you know, for having allowed this thing to happen, but they were helpless. You could always feel that from people,
The door to a negotiated settlement opened in 1991, when the federal government recognized that the park boundaries should not have included the reserve, and negotiation began on the first of Keeseekoowenin's two claims. By 2005, Canada and the First Nation had reached a settlement on both claims. All 435 hectares of the former reserve land at Clear Lake were returned to the First Nation. Keeseekoowenin also received approximately $12 million in compensation. The claim settlement also paved the way for the First Nation and Parks Canada to begin to rebuild their relationship and to find a way to work together.
We were able to negotiate something that was really very nice, and it established a senior officials forum in which the senior officials on both park side and the First Nation side would be able to sit down according to a certain protocol. The rules of the game were now set out. It wasn't the usual way of doing business.
We had not done this before, and returning lands to the First Nation, the hurt that was there, the need for reconciliation, there was a lot of just fear of the unknown. That was mitigated, though, or it was helped by the commitment of the First Nation to try and find a way to work together. We were committed to that, they were committed to that. It's made a huge difference.
Entrusted with the care and management of some of the country's most valuable resources, Parks Canada has always taken its responsibilities very seriously. But as the forum continued to meet, Parks representatives began to appreciate the value of the First Nations' insights and what would be gained by involving them in the decision-making process.
Parks for First Nations people is not a job. It's a relationship with the creatures and with the creation that makes up the park. And I think that will be a very rich contribution to be able to think of the land and the creatures of the park as part of a personal relationship. It's not simply a preservation or a protection.
Feeling pretty confident that my role here as a liaison worker and a project person, I'm feeling proud to be involved with my work and having First Nations influencing the management decisions.
In a world where past grievances and cultural misunderstanding are so often a barrier to real collaboration, Keeseekoowenin and Parks Canada have chosen a different route. The road will be a long and challenging one, but the vision both partners now share, a Wowiswajikis that honors and protects cultural heritage as well as ecological diversity, make it a journey well worth the taking.
This would not be happening without the tremendous insight and tremendous goodwill of Keeseekoowenin and Ojibwe First Nation. Without their commitment, their willingness to let us learn, to help us learn, and then find ways of working together.
In fact, Northern Ireland objectives are the same, is to make sure that the land is used, you know, for all people, as the land is reserved, you know, for the future of our people. That's our goal. That's always been our goal.